morning. Now we are going to discuss about DC machine. What is DC machine? A machine can be a motor or generator. What is the meaning of motor? Motor is a machine which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. DC motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. What is DC generator? Converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Now we are going to discuss about DC motors. I said that the electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. The DC supply will be given which is converted into mechanical energy. There are two main parts in DC motor. One is stator, another one is rotor. Stator means field winding. Rotor means armature winding. Now we are going to discuss about the working principle of DC motor. I said that two main parts, one is stator, nothing but field winding, that is the magnetic region. Field means magnetic field, which consists of a magnetic core which is wound with a copper winding. So according to the current, one will act as north pole, another one will act as south pole. Now this is stator. Rotor, that is rotating part. Now the motor working principle is, whenever a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, whenever a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, magnetic field means north pole, south pole, I said, the current carrying conductor cross and dot, this is two conductors which is placed in magnetic field. Now the force will be experienced in the two conductors so that it will rotate. How that current, the cross indicates current moving towards the plane and a dot indicates current away from the plane, like our arrow. So you can assume that in this conductor current is going towards the plane, and this conductor current is coming out from the plane. Now according to the thumb rule, the current is going inside the plane so that the flux will be produced in this direction. Now according to this, current is coming out of this plane, so flux will be in this direction. So now this conductor is placed in this magnetic region, north pole, south pole, the conductor itself having its own flux, so in this region the main flux is opposing the armature flux. So we can assume that there is no flux below the coil A. We can assume this. This is conductor A or coil A. Now, in upper region of the coil A is added with the main flux, because north pole to south pole main flux is flowing, and the armature flux itself having is its own flux direction, so that in this region more flux will be. Same way in that second coil, that is coil B, more flux will be in the downwards region, in the top region which is opposing the main flux. We can assume that there is no flux, so that we can conclude that the flux around the conductor, flux around the conductor will be more in this region and will be more in this region. So the flux path is like this. So that according to the simple concept, the elastic principle, whenever you keep a material or stone in the elastic, if you push down, it will move up. So like that, this conductor will move up due to more flux in this region. This conductor will come down, so that it will rotate in counterclockwise direction. Suppose you want to change the current direction, we can change the current direction of the coil A and B. Thank you.